Welcome back, Dark Souls fans, to Let's Die Horribly in Dark Souls 3. I'm your host, ShadowFury333, and we're still in Lothric, or the High Wall of Lothric. I imagine we're just in Lothric in the same way we're in Lordran in Game 1, so... High Wall of Lothric, I don't need to go down this ladder, what am I doing? Once again, very much near that dragon. Oh wait, that's what I'm doing. I'm going down the ladder I need to go down. And then going to face this enemy here, and the other enemy next to it. Oh, wait, no. Shoot. Not what I wanted to do. What? Go into regen mode. Okay, so what I wanted to do actually was this, which I don't think will... Whoops. Oh, it does work. Well, it doesn't actually work. They were attacking at the time. Okay, so... I feel like regen mode may not be the best idea here. I don't know how long it lasts. No, you're not close enough for it to matter. Alright, you don't get hit by fire. Well, then forget that. Oh, I see. That leads to the knight. So if I get it to attack the upper platform... Okay, that's the idea. But that means I didn't miss anything. Because this was a direct path to that knight, wasn't it? I just didn't go down the staircase, but otherwise I was at the knight. And indeed, I'm at that knight. Hello, knight. Ready for round two? Okay, I guess you are. Whoa, you definitely are ready for round two. I've got to take you seriously. Of course, I can also just put a sword through your backside. Okay, never mind. I don't need to take you seriously at all. I must say, I'm somewhat disappointed. Oh well. Anyhow, a couple more levels and that claymore will be mine to use. And otherwise, I... Oh. Right, you have a shield because you're tricky like that. Oops. It's just... It's hard to deny the regen thing when it's really cheap on mana. Oh, right! Now I remember what I'm doing. Which is basically wasting my time going along a path I've already been to get to a bonfire I've already used. Wait, did the thieves not respawn? No, the thieves respawn. See, this is exactly what I mean. Like, Dark Souls just makes you think the game is going to be... Well, last episode. Dark Souls makes you think the game is going to be easier than it is going to be. You gotta be careful about that. Might as well bonfire up. Oh, wait, shoot, no. I just realized this was a terrible idea, because there's a knight down there who now has thieves as assistants. Or the knight just goes off on its own, and I can deal with a thief at my leisure. Oops. Well, anyway... So the knight's on patrol? I gotta say, I do like that. That was something that Dark Souls 1 and 2 did not have, and Bloodborne did, which was patrolling enemies. Enemies that actually had a thing they did. Okay, well... Might as well just hit you for a couple arrows. Make you rethink your life choices. Or at least come up here and make you then definitely rethink your life choices after I... You haven't... You have throwing knives. Of course you have throwing knives. I know you have throwing knives. I also know that you have a friend, but... I'm aware you have a friend. Where's the friend? There's the friend. There's a friend, and... Rolling attack missing because the enemy moved out of the way. I'm good with that. That seems fair. Okay. I know. Goo monster down below. I should probably deal with that. But there's so much else around here. Are there any other thieves? Man, these... It's dark down here. Oh, right. Torches, I guess, are probably meant to be a thing. I'm just going to hazard a guess that I'm intended to have a torch along this area. Oh, shoot! I forgot what weapon I was using. I thought I was using a claymore, which has a thrust... Or I think it has a thrusting attack. I actually don't know what it has. I mean, I know that in... I'm pretty sure one had a thrusting... Well, one and two both had a thrusting attack. Shoot. I feel really silly right now. I also definitely feel justified in having gotten the endurance I got earlier and figure I... Okay. But yeah, I forgot longswords have a sweeping attack. Where's the enemy that I'm worried about? Okay. I forgot that it's a sweeping attack, not a thrusting attack. I was thinking it was a thrusting attack and I could just take advantage of... Oh, hey, thrusting. But no, I cannot. Oh, one-handed thrusting attack. That's why I was confused. Okay, so if I had one-handed it, I would have lived. But I two-handed it in that instance, so I died. I'm gonna two-hand it again. I may once again die. Start at health regen, because why not? Oh! That's what it is. I need to have this out the whole time. Interesting. So if I don't have it out, then I'm gonna have a hard time. Oops, way too early. I will need to learn your pattern, sir. Or madam, I can't really tell given, you know, the circumstances of being undead. I keep expecting items in here. Like, I've had no reason to believe there'd be items in these areas, but I just feel like there should be, you know? Because it's not like it'd be unprecedented. But no. Anyway, yeah, patrolling enemies, that's really cool. I'm glad they threw that in. That was a neat thing they had from an earlier... Oh. But yeah, that was a neat thing they had from... From Bloodborne. Oh, that's why I gotta be wary of fire, because these are explosive. Fire such as that, for instance. Yeah, okay, those are explosive barrels. I was exactly right. I mean, I thought they were just because clearly they made a slight error. They make an explosion sound even when you roll through them harmlessly. And then they float. Ethereal. Okay, well, bizarre collision and physics bugs aside. Yeah, I could tell there were fires from the explosions. Or the explosion sounds, so... I'm a bit surprised they didn't make it have something different, but then also do the gunpowder thing they did in 2. Because in 2, they were there, they existed, they were full of gunpowder, and you rolled through them, and they had a standard barrel break sound, but they also had gunpowder fallout. Looks like in this one it's just they have an explosion sound, and they hope that you realize an explosion sound that is totally out of place because I rolled through it and nothing exploded means that it would have normally exploded had it been broken in some alternate way. That I wouldn't have known about yet because I didn't yet actually... Well, assuming I didn't actually play any previous games, then I wouldn't know. Now, like I said, I have, so I do know, but yeah. I don't like to think in those terms, you know? It's locked. And there's someone who looks like possibly a merchant of some kind in there. Who is locked up for some reason. Possibly good reason. As I mentioned before, intelligence is my dump stat. It really is. Like, that wasn't... Oh, I guess vitality is also my dump stat. That won't be the case forever. I'm going to bump up vitality. I mean, I did point out that claymore is pretty heavy. Like, just adding claymore, that extra 9 pounds, and I'm assuming it's pounds, but an extra 9 weight puts me over the 55%, over the 50% mark, which isn't a huge mark to be worried about, but then, of course, other armor. This armor is really light. I'm hoping to get something like elite knight armor. Which won't be so light. That's more of a Fashion Souls thing, honestly. Alright, I guess I gotta deal with the goo zombie. Putting it off for long enough. That's also locked. So if I find a key, I have two locked doors I can deal with that are relatively poorly guarded. Okay. That will work for me. Now, as I recall, there was an enemy over here. Is it over the wall? Ah, okay, it was over the wall, that's why. Oops. Die, you! Well done dying! My apologies, but you carry titanite shards. Occasionally. Very occasionally. Alright, what is my health? Oh, that's actually pretty... Alright, so if I'm comfortable with the one-handing... More firebombs, and you are... Yep! Ow! Okay, repositioning. Because I don't know how to deal with this thing without proper positioning. Ow. That was not proper positioning. That was very improper positioning. I shall have to be more proper in future. But yeah, that's not too hard to get to. So actually, can I get to it from here? I can't, can I? No, I cannot. I have to go through the way I was going before. Let the knight walk along, because patrol paths are a thing. A cool thing. They are a thing. Gotta keep it in mind. And then kill the thief. Ow. You know, actually hit the thing. Oh, wait. Do I want to go into regen mode? I'm going to be using a bow and arrow to lure somebody out. Well, you know what? I don't really need to. It seems like, yeah, okay, there's a friend. But I can pretty... Whoa! I was going to say pretty quickly deal with them, but apparently no, I cannot. Not fast enough that the friend becomes totally harmless. Ah! Okay. More throwing knives. I feel like I've been giving a hint here. I feel like I should be taking the hint into account until I get my crossbow. I will indeed. Because, hey, I might as well. Alright, you are an enemy. That I can apparently one-shot and counter-hit. Assuming counter-hit damage is a thing in Dark Souls 3, it wasn't the earlier game, or it wasn't, I think it was both games. You were shielding a plunging attack. Well done. Well done, I must say. So... For the purposes of this fight, I'm going to have to deal with the fact that this guy becomes a big zombie thing that kills everything around it. Because they're all praising weird things. It does remind me of that goo monster that was... Can I go bladders? I'm curious. I just got to find out, you know? I mean, if it can, more power to it. If it can't, then I guess I just throw a knife at to death? Oh, no, I don't throw a knife at to death. Or do I? Well, I don't really want to. That takes you. Ah! The heck! Oh, wait, that's not an Estus flask. Can't I both throw enough Estus? Actually, can't come up here either, apparently. Ah! Okay, well, I can't go through the floor. Gotta respect that. Gotta figure out this thing's patterns. What the heck? I already tested those, no input lag on rolling, so I don't know what's going on. Also, how much Estus do I have? No Estus left. Okay, so we're doing this for real. One hit, and I'm dead. What the heck? Thought I rolled. Okay, I must have been unsafe on the longsword attack. I'll take that for now. I'll grant I didn't test rolling input lag when I was locked onto something that was attacking me after. Like, I didn't totally test it as thoroughly as I suppose I could have, but I'm pretty sure that was I attacked, not oh, hey, there's rolling input lag in very specific situations that I didn't happen to find when I was in the middle of the Cemetery of Ash, because the Cemetery of Ash does not contain the testing situations required to actually test that, even though I was locked onto enemies. I don't know. Sometimes things go weird. Anyhow, I think I can just deal with this guy. Clever. Ah! The cleverness is getting me killed. It's... oh, shoot. Oh, no. Oh, no. Ah! Seriously? That's 2,000! That was a whole level! Just lost a level. Well, okay, I didn't really, because soul memory is not a thing. Thank goodness soul memory is not a thing, otherwise I really would have lost a level. Would have been one level under-leveled. That's more an inconvenience. Like, 2,000 souls is still a lot, though. So I really was pretty hesitant to do this. Ah. Ah. Man, I'm not dealing with this as well as I used to. I don't know why. It used to not be a problem. Okay, you know what? Screw it. We're gonna do what I did originally, which worked well enough. Well, and not especially well in this particular instance. Although it looks like I'm not being paid attention to by the spear or the halberd wielder, so... oh, come on. Alright, where was the person I was attacking beforehand? Are they here? Oh, they're coming to the ladder. And they're dead. Which is good. But I still lost thousands of souls, which sucks. Okay, more throwing knives, which don't seem to do me a whole lot of good, so I'm not really sure what the point is at this point. Anyway, so, haul yourself up. Come on, heave-ho, don't have all day to kill you. Then the Titanite Shard potential wielders. Or holders, rather. Then you... oh, well, your shield did you no good. And what is deserter armor like? More physical... ooh, a lot more physical resistance. Hmm. Yeah, I'm gonna wear this for now. I have soot all over my face. I am sooted. Actually, I feel like it's more of an environmental cue thing, like... you deal some damage or whatever, and you get soot all over your face as a result. Actually, you know what? Do I want to do that? It's probably suicide, but at the same time, it does mean I have more hits before I die. Yeah, let's use it. Let's human up. Ember restored! Okay, it's Ember up. How much health do I have? Oh, wait, no, that's... oh, it heals me completely, too! Okay, cool. It's a bit better than it was in 2, where it didn't heal you completely, and you were kind of stuck. In this case, it does heal you completely. Also, I might as well go with a bit of health regen, as much as it's not the best option, I suppose, but... oh! Oh, you can kill that thing before it goes... oh! Okay, so I guess I don't learn its patterns, because I just killed the thing before it became the thing. I killed the thing when it was normal. Do I get only the souls I'd get for killing the thing as... a hollow? Like, just the standard hollow souls? Or do I get souls for killing the thing as a... Titanite Lizard! That doesn't try to kill me! That doesn't fall off of cliffs! Thank you, merciful Titanite Lizard, for not falling off a cliff! Because, frankly, that was the most annoying thing about Titanite Lizards. They fall off things. But this Titanite Lizard was courteous enough not to jump down to here where another knight is. And a bunch of knights are dead. Oh. Okay. Very dead. Is that just a leg? Yeah, that's just a leg, or leg armor at least. Okay, so... some knights died horribly. I can sympathize. Dying horribly is what I do well. Or occasionally killing things before they have a chance to kill me, which... is not really exactly the cleric way, but... it's the way. It's the way I do. Or get done too, as the case may be. Ah! Okay, this is not gonna work. This is where... seriously, give me those bloody crossbows already! Give me your crossbows! Please! I gotta say, Dark Souls 3 has been pretty consistent about if you see a thing that looks like you could just kill it, it's bait. And you might want to actually invest in a ranged option, which we're not gonna give you for some reason. Other than the bow. I guess they gave me the bow. But, you know, something... Or the throwing knives. I guess they gave me the throwing knives. I should probably use those a bit more. Firebomb. And also they give me firebombs. Alright, alright. I'm complaining out of nowhere. Never mind. They give you stuff. They don't give you the stuff I want, but they do give you stuff. So in fairness, they do give you stuff. I will grant that I was being a little bit too... Oh, wait a sec. Something's wrong here. No, not that guy. That guy I expected. It's these two that are the problem, which... See, this is the problem I have with throwing knives. They're not very damaging. Like, they're not bad for something that's trying to run away from you. Oh, there you are. Okay, where's the enemy in this room? It's over to my right. And another Titanite shard. Okay, I can upgrade the... Actually, how many do I have right now? Three? Okay, so I could upgrade one of my weapons to... I could upgrade the sword to plus two if I have yet another one. I could upgrade the claymore to plus one. I could upgrade the chime, possibly boost the spell power. How much souls do I have? 660. Okay, well, there's no reason to go back now. Undead Hunter Charm? The heck is that? I missed what kind of... Oh. Lloyd's Talisman. Okay, there's Lloyd's Talisman. Yep. All for Lloyd. Okay, so yeah, that's what it is. No SS recovery, and you can disable mimics for free. So I guess if you go this way before you... Hang on. Let me think. Yeah, okay. Actually, you know what? That kind of makes sense, because that mimic is behind the dragon. So, if it's their first time going through... No, actually, why would you throw a Lloyd's Talisman at a dragon, though? Unless, not a dragon. Why would you do that? Why would you throw it at a mimic, though, unless you already knew that that was a thing? Like, if you know that's a thing, then sure, throw it at a mimic all you want, like, all day. Because mimics are super vulnerable to that. Great idea. But, otherwise, I don't really see the point. Ooh, Lothric Knight leggings. Put me over the 50-degree edge, but pretty good. Pretty decent. Actually, come to think of it, I'm going to put in deserter trousers. I'm going to be like a deserter. Actually, that explains what's going on here. Or it would if I were to actually read through the descriptions of that, probably. Let's... You... Whatever. What are your... Rusty hung a metal befits one reduced to thievery. Okay. The knight has served as one of the three pillars since ancient times and shares a place alongside the Wyverns as a symbol of Lothric. Only those possessing a knight's resolve are fit to wear this garment. That probably does not include me, because frankly, I have a tendency to be a bit more pragmatic than I am honorable. Despite the fact that death is... I was wondering where an ambush is going to come from. Like, where's the enemy gonna be this time? It's to the left. And what are you? So yeah, I guess in fairness, now that I think about this is the path that most players are gonna go on first because the dragon is so intimidating you wouldn't go for it. But still, you don't get any chests unless this path has chests. Well, on the other hand, you can go past the dragon and then turn left. Oh no, you can't, no, because the door doesn't open from that side. I don't want to open from the inside. That was a one-way door. Right, okay. That was a shortcut to the mimic area, but it's a shortcut. It's a one-way door. I just happened to go through it the hard way first. Oh. Okay, so it's not the first chest you'd encounter if you went through the easy way first. You'd encounter this chest. All right, I retract my statement from the previous episode. You do actually find chests that are not just mimics right off the bat. Unless you go through the hard way, which I guess actually doesn't make a lot of sense, because they're basically going, okay, well, you have the guts to take on a dragon, that means you're probably a veteran. You probably have played this game before, these games before. You probably know what's up. You probably know that mimics are a thing. And we're going to sick one on you just to double check. And, well, okay. Well done. I got to say, given that I can see the line of reasoning that would lead to that. I can see that. That's actually... pretty valid. I'll go with that. I still think it's weird that that mimic is that early, though. But yeah, I guess, like I said, this game is designed for veterans. Is there a way to get through here that doesn't involve aggroing everything? There is. And that was not it. Although, actually, it was, kind of, because enemies actually care about sight ranges. Ah, what the heck? Would you just not... Would you just not? Just please don't. I'm not sure what I think about the health regeneration thing. On the one hand, health regeneration that's tied to magic, tied to resource like that, I guess that kind of makes sense. On the other hand, and also you have to have that weapon out so you're stuck one hand and you can't use a bow or anything. Okay, I'll grant that. But on the other hand, it's still health regeneration, so it doesn't quite have the same sense of resource management that you normally get. Wow, misjudged spacing hard. You, however, misjudged height. Ah, and I misjudged timing. Okay, misjudgments all around. Let's have a recess and reconvene in 20 minutes because that is going to be when we'll all have our heads about us and can actually make correct judgments. Although, come to think of it, I think we'll just have to adjourn court for today. You don't seem to be in particularly good health. Nor do you. Oh, wait, I can't kill these on a full stamina bar yet. I'm so close. How much Estus do I have? Okay, I can Ashen Estus up. I'm not sure if I want to... I think I'll go for the... The regen thing is so strong. That's the one thing. It's like, as long as I'm not being attacked directly, and there are stints where I'm just not attacked directly, it's pretty strong. Estus Shard, yes! That is a great find. That's a wonderful find. It's like one of the better finds I could find, and now I can kill you with one stamina bar because I have enough firepower to do so. Or my stamina to do so, and you were slightly damaged. Okay. Alright, so this is the area I found before, and oh wow, that's a giant knight there. Okay. Are those wings? Or, I should be more precise, are those decorative or functional wings? Well, anyhow, I don't really want to drop down there. Is there a staircase? There's usually not... If there's a one-way trip somewhere, there's usually a way back up. And usually, unless there's a one-way door, that way back up can also be a safer way down. Like, sure, for someone who's impatient, you can go through it that way, and it looks like that's not an option. However, given the circumstances, where am I? Oh! I'm a ways away from the last bonfire, aren't I? And I don't have... Yeah, I have the SS Flash Shard, which is nice, but... How much SS have I used? One Ashen, which I will probably shift to Ashen, because that is really handy. Alright, what else is here? I saw dogs here. I know I saw dogs here. There were dogs here, right? That was a thing. And the answer is decorative. Now, the bigger question... Other than, how much would you like a plunging attack on your head? The correct answer is obviously, very much, sir, please may I have another. Oh, hey, attack to the head. Because why not? Okay. Well, that answers the question of, are there assistants? The answer was, yes. Yes, there were. They got plunging attacks. Because that's how I do. Okay, so I think this is going to be a good place to end it. I do want a bonfire, though. Oh, another ember. Awesome, I didn't waste the one I used. Well, okay, I haven't died yet, so I guess I haven't really wasted anything. Okay. So these are all empty husks of armor. I don't like that. One of these is going to wake up on me. Or be an actual knight or something. I just know it. Because Dark Souls would do that. What's this? Another ember, okay. Oh, I know what this is. So, this is a Bloodborne reference, not a Dark Souls reference. There's an area in Bloodborne, near the beginning, where it's a wide open area, and you have a relatively tough enemy. It's actually the Brain Suckers, which are even harder than that knight was by a wide margin. And you get a bunch, in that case, it was a bunch of insight. A bunch of the... Oh, I can't remember the name of it right now. It was the one insight item. Like... I can't remember what it was. Like hidden, it wasn't hidden knowledge, but it was one of those knowledge items. And it was a bunch of them, a big arena full of them. And it was basically, you go to this area and you can get a bunch of items for multiplayer. Now, of course, in Bloodborne, you use one insight every single time you join someone multiplayer or invade somebody. Now, of course, in Dark Souls, you don't use one Ember Humanity for that purpose. You actually gain them by doing so. Wait, that... Oh, yeah, so it just means, I guess, you get to see other people. You get to summon other people. You can't summon people unless you're human. Or, in this case, Ember. But you can be summoned without using it, whereas in Bloodborne, you have to use Insight in order to be summoned. So that's what it's kind of a reference to. Bit of an obscure reference for those who haven't played Bloodborne, but yeah, that's a Bloodborne reference. So I don't see any bonfires anywhere nearby at all. This is rather concerning. Ah. When you hear a shot fire, roll. Don't wait to see where it's coming from, just roll. 50-50, you'll roll in the right direction. Oops. Ow. Okay. Not ideal. There's gotta be a trap here. There's always gotta be a trap. Always how it is, look for the trap. Oh, they actually improved how throwing knives work. You can just throw a bunch of them. That's cool. I do notice that with Dark Souls 3. I did notice that with the small things I was spoiled with, which this is not among them. We are well into areas that I have no idea how they work. But yeah, one thing I did notice is that your overall mechanics, overall combat mechanics are a lot faster, a lot slicker. It's a lot easier to just do things in a way that's just viscerally enjoyable. Whereas in Dark Souls 1 and 2, like Dark Souls 1 especially, was actually kind of slower. Dark Souls 2 was faster, but it was weird because the enemies kind of got sped up more than the player did. Anyhow, I'm... Okay, if this is not a bonfire, we're just going to end without a bonfire, which I guess will happen from time to time. No, it's not. This is going to be a longer episode. Oh! Oh, what? So, how do you get over there? Seriously, how do you get over there? Okay, so... Is this... I think if I jump... I obviously thought if I jumped... Actually, no, if I jump from here... Will that work? It looks like it might. Well, rolling certainly won't. Jumping, you do get height. Okay, you do get height for jumping. Wow, you get hit hard for rolling. Not rolling, sorry, falling. Get hit hard for falling. Maybe it is like two. There just aren't. There just isn't a gutter area that makes it really obvious. Okay, so run. Nope. Oh no, no, it's not that. Oh, she is pretty harsh. That'd have been no damage in one. Okay, so it looks like falling is probably on the same lines as two. But I have no cat here to give me a silver cat ring to go and not take falling damage. Alright, so... Like the other area... There we go. That was easy enough. Ring of Sacrifice. Okay. Of course, that raises the question. Now, see, in Ring of Sacrifice, we have four rings. What does it mean for it to break, though? Those of you not familiar, this one, as the description describes, if you die, you don't lose your souls or your ember status. You do... If petrification or curse exists in this game, which I don't... Curse exists, so if curse works like it did in 1, because I'm assuming it doesn't just... It's not going to reduce your health as it did in 2, since that's not a mechanic in the same way. Okay, so it doesn't say what curse is. Curse is probably petrification. Curse is probably the way it was in 1, where you get cursed, you turn to stone, you die, you come back with half health. Although I guess in this case, dying just causes you to come back with reduced health anyway. And then you become... So that becomes a bit of a harder thing. Green Blossom. All right, so Stamina Regen. That's a Stamina Regen item. Use it, you get more stamina. Well, you get stamina faster. You don't actually get more stamina. Oh, shoot, no, no. No, 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 no. Not without at least quaffing a bit of Estus. Okay, okay, now I got it. I'm getting tired. This is going to be the last episode for tonight. So, for those of you not familiar with how Let's Play recording usually works, it's long sessions. And this is going to be the last one of this session, because I'm clearly getting tired, and I'm falling for the psychological tricks that I pointed out and caught out by intuition not an hour ago. Is this broken? Oh no, it's just an elevator. Elevator up? Yeah, it's an elevator up. Elevator up to an area I've been to before, because that's most likely how this is going to work. It's going to be a shortcut, because that's how Dark Souls is designed properly. And hey, it's a shortcut! I think. Looks like it's a shortcut back to the area that I was at back when I went... Oh no, it's the axe guy. Well, so much for shortcut. Oh well, I'm dead. On the bright side, that's a pretty close area to find my souls. On the downside, those are the axe and halberd guys. Not fun. Anyhow, not too hard to deal with though. So go to the left, get my souls, and then we'll deal with that. Oh right, go to the other bonfire. Get my souls, and then deal with all the other stuff in the next episode. So stay tuned for that when that'll come out. And until then, have a good one. Good night, everyone.